Hello guys, good evening. I'll start with my forex analysis for this week. As usual, first I'll be discussing about dollar index chart and then I'll move to individual currencies and I'll also discuss few commodities like gold and oil. Starting with dollar index, like you can notice clearly that dollar index has closed like a half body, half wick candle, which clearly represents a clear rejection, I mean indecision in the market, not the rejection. If you notice last week also there was indecision in the market, and this week's candle, if you notice, it has a wick which is clearly showing rejection of the buyers, basically sellers dominance, but a bullish closing body shows buyers dominance. So half body, which is indicating for buyers momentum, and half wick, which is indicating for sellers momentum. Again, it's a clear indication of indecision in the market. Also, if you see, there was a spinning top, ideally candle closing above the high would have confirmed for buy, but market did not close above the high. It exactly closed at the high or lower, a little lower. So again, you can see that market is mainly trying to decide and it's moving in a range. So for this week also, I would suggest you the same thing what I suggested you last week, that go with daily closings because weekly is looking very indecisive. Another reason is after such a big movement, market is also trying to settle down. There's not much momentum in the market. All you can do more is of a range bound trading just now. Buy at the support, sell at the resistance. So I'll discuss the daily chart as well. So if you notice here, you can clearly, now you can figure out that why I'm saying that market is moving in a range. You can see that this is the range of resistance. Market is moving in between that. And this is your support area, right? So if the market is at the resistance, like today's Friday closing happened at the resistance. So today you can be on the sell side. Then again, as per the candle close, you can continue to be on the sell side till this support area, okay? If you get a bullish candlestick confirmation like something like this, then you can be on the buying side. So basically, you can prefer doing range-bound trading. If you're not able to draw the trend lines, if you follow Fibonacci, then you can draw the Fibonacci from low to high. Okay. You can clearly see that market is ranging in between 23.6 to 50%. See, it's coinciding. Both the trend lines are coinciding. And that's how you know you have drawn a correct trend line. Most of them will coincide with your Fibo levels as well. Also, if you see, there's an in between 38.2%. So if market closes below 38.2, then you can continue to hold on to your trade till 50%. If it rejects 38.2, then you can switch to buy and you can target till 23.6. So you should, what you should focus on is should be more of range bound trading from one level to another level and stick to your daily time frame, at least for this week again, because weekly closings are not very clear. They're very indecisive. Market is showing momentum on both the sides, divided momentum. So it would be better that we utilize this as a trading in between the consolidation, in between the range. Buy at the support, sell at the resistance, just target 1:2. And you can come out of the market. Okay. So that's what you can focus this week. So each chart I'll be discussing both. I'll be showing you the weekly indecision and then I'll be switching to the daily chart as well. Starting with Euro USD. So first I'll check the weekly time frame. So like you can see the indecision in the market. It's a clear spinning top, right? It's just opposite of what we saw in dollar index, because here the dollar is the second pair. So that's why Euro USD is just opposite. Their dollar was in the daily chart was indicating more towards the sell side. That's why it is at the support in case of Euro USD. So I'll again go to my daily time frame. So check the direction in the daily time frame. And as per the daily time frame, you can take a trade setup. So if you notice here, you can draw the support like this as well. And another way of drawing the support is also this. And you already have a candlestick confirmation for a buy. So today you can be on the buying side. As per today's close, you can again decide to continue to be on the buying side. If it's rejecting, then accordingly you can take a decision. And again, you should draw the resistance. So this would be more like a resistance. You can draw it this way. Or another way of figuring out the resistance would be connecting to these points. See, 1, 2, 3. So now in this case, what you can expect is if the market breaks out above this level, which means market is indicating for buy till the next resistance level, which is this, right? If it breaks out above, then again, you can target till this resistance level. So level by level, you can decide. First resistance will be this, okay. Second resistance will be, which is a strong resistance, will be this, okay. So instead of, I use more of trend lines, also you can do is you can clear off everything and you can just draw a Fibonacci if you don't know how to draw trend lines. And in this case, you should draw the Fibonacci from this to this, okay. From major swing high to low, you can also draw from this level till this level, depending on your perspective. Here I'm trying to decide the direction, so that's why I'm taking a longer perspective. Also, if you want to draw the Fibonacci from, let's say, low to high, you can also do that. It would just be a little shorter term perspective. See this one? Okay. So here you can check your levels, but I would definitely prefer from high to low. So that's about Euro USD. Check each and every level, just now indicating for buy till the next sub resistance level. So then again, moving to GP USD. GP USD, first we can check the weekly time frame. So weekly time frame, like you can see that last week we were bearish on GBP on the basis of this breakout pullback setup, if you remember. And it actually worked also. In the market did went down, though eventually it closed a little higher, but it's still closing below the low of the previous candle, which indicates a clear sell setup. You can draw a better trend line by connecting further. So it will look more strong, right? Also, if you have, again, not comfortable with trend line, you can draw a Fibonacci. And you can clearly notice it's rejecting 50% here, right? So again, this week also I'll be bearish on GP USD. This is, so on a weekly time frame, GBP is clearly indicating that it's on the sell side, okay? The dollar looks indecisive, but still GBP looks bearish. And to have a better confirmation, I would still say keep checking your daily closes in this case also. So if we open the daily time frame, see, if you zoom out your chart, you can clearly see a breakout pullback setup. One way of drawing the trend line is this. See? Right? If you see that mark, you, what you can expect when we draw this trend line is, mark, you can get a sell setup somewhere around this zone. Wherever you get a bearish candlestick confirmation, you can prefer to be on the sell side. So when I said this is one way, and this could be another way of drawing the... So whichever way you are able to figure out the trend line, you can draw that way. This way also is another way of drawing it. So your support and resistance could differ. I mean, your drawing of trend lines would differ on the basis of how you are able to see the market. But I am trying to show you all the perspectives and you can choose any one of those. If you're able to see both, then nothing like it. So what you are waiting just now, see, after seeing here on a daily time frame and weekly, we're on the sell side, don't switch to buy. Basically, wait for a market to reach the resistance as it's Monday, wait for proper pullback, and then you can wait for a sell confirmation, okay? Also, you can see that this might form a head and shoulder pattern also, and this is a head and one shoulder and second shoulder is under formation. So you can check out that as well. Once the formation is complete and the second shoulder is formed and this would be the neckline and after breakout of that. So it is under formation. It is not formed completely yet. The shoulder, the second shoulder is still forming. So you can keep that also in mind. So that's about GP USD. GP, you should be on the sell side. Same if you go with New Zealand USD, again, first the weekly time frame. If you check the weekly, again, an indecision in the market, right? But if you see the overall setup, you will get a better idea in the sense that you can figure out the breakout pullback setup here, which is very clean. You can see it's a very strong support, which was broken during the Corona news, you can see, and then you can see the market is doing the pullback and trying to settle till here. So you would be able to figure out once you have a candlestick confirmation, then you can be on the sell side. So best is you can go to the daily time frame and same trend line is applicable. See, if you zoom out your chart, you will be able to figure it out. Right. So what you have to do is you have to wait for a bearish candlestick confirmation formed around this area, and then you can be on the sell side. If the market breaks out above, then that's when we can switch to buy. So as per every day closes, so at least for this week, I would suggest wait for Monday closings and accordingly you can trade in the market. So AUD, USD. So if you would have noticed today, I'm not talking much about correlation because weekly correlation are the best because it tells you the perspective of the entire week. Rather going on smaller time frame correlation, I prefer it doing on a weekly time frame. Since weekly is very indecisive, so this week we are not concentrating much on correlation. And also when the market is range bound, you can trade on both the sides, buy at the support, sell at the resistance. Correlation is mainly focused on one direction, like which side you like. You choose one strong, one weak to be on towards one direction of the market. So I would say wait for that thing for this week. Maybe this week the markets might give you some perspective which side of the direction it should be. Like for example, here as well, if you see, the market is currently going up, but it looks like more like a pullback. I hope you're able to figure out what I'm about to draw. See? Can you see the support line breaking out and then it's trying to do the pullback? So till here you can be on the buying side, okay, on a daily time frame. I'm not saying you cannot buy, you can capture the move from here to here because it's more than 100-200 pips. You can still capture it, but once the market reaches here, then you can switch to sell. So maybe this week closing might give us a better perspective on which side of the market we should be. Okay, so this week we are not focusing much on correlation. We are doing simple trading of 1:2 risk to reward. Daily time frame, we are checking the direction. And on a smaller time frame, whichever time frame you're comfortable with, hourly, 4-hourly, or lesser than that, you can go for the entry. Okay, so again, going back to the daily time frame here. See, I'll just remove the trend line here. So if you see, the daily time frame is clearly indicating currently like a upside move. Market is going up, doing a pullback, again going up, doing the pullback. So market is expected to go till the next resistance again, which is nothing but this level. You can draw the horizontal trend line is working very well in this case. There's a strong support broken out and the pullback, market can again go and test this level. So on the basis of closings, you can decide. Again, I would suggest if you're not able to draw trend lines properly, then use the Fibonacci from high to low. And see, it is currently exactly at 61.8, which is another very strong resistance just now. Why I'm calling it as resistance? Because market is playing below 61.8. If the daily closing happens above 61.8, so you can be on the buy side and you can buy till 78.6 and see my trend line is exactly again coinciding with the same. I'll add my moving averages as well. So from here, exponential and weighted. You can use others as well as per your convenience. So it helps you to create a confluence area. Sorry, this one 200, I'll just, and weighted, I prefer using 30. Okay, see why I applied the moving average, because see, now it became such a strong confluence. My 200, my trend line 78.6, everything is coinciding here. So if the candle closes bullish above 61.8, it's clearly indicating to buy. So maybe tomorrow, if you get a confirmation, you can be on the buying side and your take profit should be here. But as in when you see the market has reached here, it will take your take profit. Then wait for a bearish candlestick confirmation to switch to sell. So that should be your plan for this week. Trade on whichever side, but trade buy at the support, sell at the resistance. So again, moving to the next dollar pair, which is USD CAD. I'll first open the weekly time frame. See, weekly, if you see, again, it's clearly showing rejections, but USD CAD still, it's more rejection is completely of the buyers, basically showing sellers' momentum for the market to go down. Because before discussing USD CAD, I can first discuss oil. So if you notice, oil has clearly, I mean, it has touched a very low price, which is, I haven't touched till now. And because there's very low consumption of oil because of the lockdown, and fundamentally it has become very, very weak. So just now it's trying to settle down, but believe me, guys, it's too early to buy and it's too late to sell. Again, I would repeat that. Wait for the market to settle down, because fundamentally still oil is weak. So don't think in a perspective that if I buy at this price, it is very good to invest for long term. Yes, you can buy, but buy after confirmation, not at the current situation. So I would suggest not to get into oil currently. Wait for some time. Let's see how it works out. But definitely it would try to settle down a little. So basically it would try to cover up. So like it is currently at the price of 13, what it's showing, 13 point something or 14. So it would try to settle and be a little range bound in between 20 to 10, in between that price it will be. But don't buy at this price thinking that it's a very low price to buy. Just that reason is not good enough. Because the way fundamentally it's still weak, still there's low consumption of oil, right? So don't sell and don't buy. Don't do anything with oil. Just try to observe and stay out. If you had to sell, it had a very clear confirmation of breakout pullback. I discussed this in my weekly analysis also. There was a clear breakout pullback setup, and this was the best price to enter for sell. You can draw it in this way. You can also draw it horizontally. Both ways, you can draw it. Okay. So this is the price where I also sold oil, but I came out after this here, after this bullish candlestick confirmation around these prices, I came out. So this much fall is good to trade with. But don't trade after this level where there's no confirmation just now. There's no stability just now, to say it in best terms. So try to stay out of oil. But yes, Canadian dollar, you can see some strength because oil is trying to pick up. So as a currency also, USD CAD is, dollar is more on the weak side. CAD is looking to pick up a little. So USD CAD is indicating for sell. Also on a daily time frame, like we are trading for all the pairs on a daily time frame. See, you can draw these levels. Just a second. See, this is the resistance you can see, and this is the support you can draw. And market, if you see, is in between just now. So if the market breaks out the spinning top on the upside, then you can sell at the resistance when the market reaches the resistance. So basically what I'm trying to say, either buy at the support, sell at the resistance. So USD CAD overall, if you want to sell also, sell at these prices. Or if you want to buy, then buy at these prices. So wait for the market to do its movement, and whichever side it goes, like for example here, it was good to sell. Here it's good to buy. So that way, keep that in mind. So now moving to next pair, which is USD JPY. Okay. USD JPY, again, I will start with weekly. Weekly candle, again, you can see an inside bar, a very small candle, not much momentum. And it's more like a spinning top or basically an indecision. So again, we'll focus more on a daily time frame. So daily time frame also, you can clearly notice it's like a consolidation. So this is the support. If market breaks this support, then definitely you should be on the sell side, because then you will see a vertical fall happening, because the market happened vertically. Okay. If it takes a support and market goes up, then this you can trade as per the resistance. So this could be your resistance level. You can connect with the past area and you can draw your resistance line. Or if you have issues with drawing the trend line, again, I would suggest you to draw a Fibonacci level. From low to high, and see you have your levels. So around in this case, it's not exactly touching 50%. So if you have a scenario where market is in between 38.2 to 52, then you should draw your support level with a trend line, right? But your stop losses, if you're buying, you should keep it below 50%. In case you're buying, you should keep it because there would be a possibility of market to spike till this level, 50%. And your resistance becomes 23.6, right? So that's the range you can trade with. But if USD JPY breaks this level, then it's a very good sell. Basically, dollar becomes weak and JPY becomes strong. So it would be more because JPY became strong and market is falling well. So you can keep an eye on that. Keep your daily closing under check and you can trade accordingly. Now, last one is USD CHF. After that, I'll discuss gold also. So before getting into the daily time frame, I'll just show you the weekly. So weekly again, if you see, half wick, half body. Wick is representing seller's dominance, right? And body is showing you the buyer's dominance. So basically, it's an indecision in the market. And now, if you open the daily time frame, Daily time frame still has good clarity. Why? Because you can see 200 moving average acting as a resistance and we have a rejection candlestick. So USD CHF is basically indicating for a sell. So as per daily time frame, if you would have noticed by now, dollar is more indicating, I mean, towards the sell side for few days. And this could be your support trend line. Okay. See? So if you're selling, you can target till here, or what you can do directly for the support, if you're not able to figure out the trend line, because that was a little complicated one, you can just directly draw a Fibonacci retracement. See, market is just now playing around 23.6. If the candle closes below 23.6, you can target till 38.2, then 50, then 61.8, and likewise. So just bottom line is trade as per daily confirmations. And here already USD CHF has confirmed for daily. So if you're selling also, you can sell and you should keep your stop loss above this level. So that's about USD CHF. So all the dollar pairs, though, for like at least 1-2 days, dollar is indicating for a sell in the daily closes, what we have noticed till now. With all the pairs, there's a scope. But like, for example, let's say in case of AUD USD, right? AUD USD dollar sell means AUD USD buy, right? It has a scope to go up till here. So what I'm trying to say is you buy for 1 or 2 day, but as in market is reached the resistance, or in case of USD CHF, it reads the support, then you should cut your trade, come out of the trade and see if you have a confirmation of the candle and accordingly trade. So it's indicating for sell, dollar is indicating for sell, but I would say support is nearby. Or in case of AUD USD, it's indicating for buy, but resistance is just next level. Okay, so just keep that in mind. Now, last, I'll be discussing about gold as I missed that. So XAU USD. So gold, again, talking about the weekly time frame. I'll delete everything first. So if you remember, there was a pin bar and that's why we were expecting the gold to fall down. But if you notice, again, there is more of indecision, I'll call, though the market has closed bullish, but it hasn't broken the high, okay? Or it hasn't broken our resistance, what we were expecting last time, right? If it would have broken the high with this body dominating candle, then it would have clearly confirmed for buy. If this high would have been broken with a body dominating candle. But if you see, neither the high is broken nor the low is broken. Again, the market is trying to decide which side it should get into momentum. So again, you should trade on a, instead of a weekly time frame, this week you should trade on a daily time frame. And if daily closes below this low, it will form an evening star. So then for next few days, you can be on the sell side. So accordingly, as per just now, if daily closes below the low, it is the resistance. So it's a very nice setup. Sell at the resistance. Targeting till the support. In this case, it would be very good to draw a Fibonacci as well because from low to very clear swing high. Okay. So first target could be till here. which is our moving average also, right? And which is our breakout pullback level as well. See, resistance, breakout, turning into support. So if you're selling at around this price, you can expect the market to come down around this price and test it. So just concentrate on daily closings and don't get into much of correlation, because correlation works on weekly time frame for the direction purpose. Just identify the whether the market is at the support or at the resistance. Sell at the resistance, buy at the support. Decide the direction on a daily time frame. Enter on a smaller time frame and just target for 1:2 or max to max 1:3, and you can come out of the trade. Then next week we'll see if we have confirmations. If dollar index gives a confirmation, then all the currencies also you will see that way. But as dollar index is looking indecisive, that's why the market is very indecisive on a longer time frame, which is a weekly time frame. So just stick to your daily time frames and keep trading. Trade with proper risk management. And that's it for this week. We'll meet again next Monday. Thank you guys. Have a good trading week.